Namaste. Bees are really fascinating. And I consider myself a very lucky one because I have been working with bees since 9 years. You know, unlocking their mystery, their magical world. So I enjoyed a lot since 9 years. Now, bees, beehive, is an example of sustainable system. They have complex social system, a beehive. They have distribution of labor. They have different roles. Worker bees, different roles. And they perform a specific role according to their age. So many of the management system, many of the structure in our society is adapted by bees at a beehive. So today, we will try to understand what is Indian beekeeping and bees in India's perspective. Because as the earlier speaker said, whatever data that we are referring and studying, it is all the Western side. So we need to look at what Indians need with the perspective of beekeeping. So bees are required for pollination. You know, scientists say that bees have 3 million hairs on their body. They accommodate a lot of pollen when they go to, when they visit to flowers. They accommodate a lot of pollen on their body and cross to the female flowers or the female part of the flower. So that is how pollination is done. And that is when you get to eat. Now, as the coordinator said that, you know, 1/3 of the food is from bees. Every third spoon that you are eating right now is a contribution of a honeybee. Now, honeybees are really gentle to the nature. You know, when they visit the flower will give them a prize. What is that? Nectar and few pollen. Nectar is their source of glucose and fructose, and pollen is their source of protein. So they only depend on these two things. And many of the times, we don't know that there are many industries which are dependent on bees. For example, coffee, oil industry, renewable energy industry, transportation industry, textile industry. So all these things are interrelated to bees. Let me tell you about coffee. You know, coffee is an industry, it's a big industry. India is one of the leading exporter of coffee. And, you know, we have many employment which is dependent on coffee industry. Coffee, especially the Robusta, it depends on bee pollination. If bees are in a verge of extinction, are in a decline, you won't get any seed set from coffee. So when industry falls down, employment falls down, it happens with oil industry as well, renewable energy. A lot of biodiesel like Jatropha and Pongamia, Simaruba, all those seeds are used for renewable source of fuel. So all those things will come down. And not forgetting the food. Now the main source of food is pulses, fruits and vegetables. So all the fruits, almost all the fruits. There are crops which are pollinated by self. But still, scientists say that in self-pollinated crops also, if bees go and visit and do their stuff, 10% of increase in yield can be achieved. So this is how we can really relate. You know, because I get a lot of calls from the farmers who are doing their agricultural activity inside the poly house, the greenhouses. You know, the majority of the crops which are grown inside the greenhouses are self-pollinated because we cannot keep bees inside. However, in Europe and other countries, they are using bumblebees inside the poly houses for the pollination. Corporate planters, corporate vegetable growers, they understand the significance of cross-pollination. But my worry is the common farmer, no, the normal farmer, he's not understanding the significance of pollination. So along with global warming, along with climate change, there is another burning topic which is, you know, which is being discussed across the globe, is decline of bees, colony collapse disorder. And let me tell you, colony collapse disorder is not an Indian issue. However, we will probably have to coin a different name for this. We are not experiencing the same problem the way the West is experiencing, but we have different issues, different challenges. So the main challenge is pesticides, herbicides, weedicides. So when a pesticide is sprayed on any crop, and due to some ignorance of a farmer, could be like that, or anyway, you know, when you see disease, a farmer will be, you know, forced to spray something because he has no alternatives for that. So he sprays something, and this is the result. When you spray something on the flower, and bees will die. You know, this colony, if you observe, all the bees are coming towards entrance to the platform of a beehive, and they are dead. So let us understand how bees will experience when they get through the pesticide spray. Now they have 10 patches. They like other insects, they have external respiratory system. So they have 10 patches where they respire. So when the pesticides come to their body, and there will be a thin film, they get intoxicated highly. Sometimes they forget the way back to their home. Sometimes they die on the field. Sometimes when they come back, when they sense something is wrong, they would like to go out and die. In the absence of guard bees, yes, they have guard bees, they have nursing bees, they have comb builders. So different criteria will be there, different hierarchy will be there inside the beehive. So in the absence of guard bees, ants will take over, kill their all larvae, take their pollen, nectar, everything. So this is what we are experiencing in the agriculture. Yes, for nutrition and for the food, we require a surplus amount of supply. But still, when we spray something, bees are giving you a message. If I am dying, then what are you eating? So when we talk about bees and bee decline, it is not just about social bees. You know, there are 20,000 species of bees in the world, and very few are social. And in those social bees, we have, you know, the beekeeper fraternity, we have finalized with very few cavity nesting bees which can be domesticated. So the global outcry about the bee decline is not only referred for the bees which we are, you know, domesticating for commercial reasons. There are solitary bees, solitary cousins of social bees. They are also very much required for pollination. So each flower will be designed for a particular pollinator. If you see this image, there is a platform created for a pollinator to sit and do pollination. So flowers are really serious about it. So farmers are not. We are not serious about it. Because we belong to subtropical country. We had a bounty of nature, you know, all the diversity of flora, fauna, pollinators, insects, many, many things. But because of the loss of habitat, we are experiencing this issue. And the pesticides, which is spray, you know, being sprayed in all the crops, sometimes it will not be required, But still, farmer will be really, you know, scared of something. You know, fear of failure will make him to spray something, which is really bad for bees. When bees are hurt, everything will be at stake. So this is a blue-banded bee, and it is pollinating some sort of crop. And this is a carpenter bee. Now, carpenter bee is also a solitary bee, often mistook as bumblebee. Bumblebees in India only exist in higher altitudes like Jammu and Himachal. So these bees' nests are usually destroyed because they are borers. They weaken the wooden structures in villages. So they spray something and the carpenter bees will die. They collect a lot of pollen. While collecting pollen from one plant to another plant, you know, the size will be really big like this. You might have seen in this campus as well. It's a really big bee. So all these solitary bees are at stake. But we get to notice only the social bees because we rear them. We are attached to them. So along with this, let me talk about something which is hampering beekeeping industry and also the consumer's health. When we talk about malpractice of honey, adulteration of honey, we will never know, as a consumer, we will never know that this honey is pure or not. Whatever certification which is the Indian government has finalized, it is outdated. The criteria are outdated. So high fructose corn syrup, invert sugar solution, so all those things are coming into India, and you mix 80% of it and 20% pure honey, it will become honey as per the Indian standard. So we are diluting our own market by purchasing such things. And very unfortunately, a commodity called artificial honey is being listed in a GST commodity list very recently. It is like stamping and licensing a commodity which can be used for diluting this whole intention. So they are giving the promotion for that. So it is not that it is a poison, but your whole purpose will be lost. Honey is natural sugar, enzymes, polyphenols, and some pollen, which gives you a lot of energy. And not only that, we have references in Ayurveda. Almost all the Ayurvedic medicines will be consumed by honey, by taking along with honey. So we have to attach importance for what we are buying. Yeah, how we can really contribute to take up this activity in a bigger level. It is not that Indian government is not doing anything. In horticulture department, we can buy beehive boxes in subsidized rate. Forest department is contributing by giving beehive boxes to the tribal villages, which is adjoining to the forests. And Khadi and Village Industries Commission has started Honey Mission, which is launched across the country. It is happening in a big level. So the only thing is implementation, timing. When farmers require pollination, beehive should be there at their farm. Usually what happens with the government, the passing bill and everything, the bureaucracy, everything will be delayed. When his crops are gone, the beehives will be there. So implementation. So we have to rethink about it. And whatever I have seen, you know, I travel a lot. So whatever I have seen from Indian agricultural perspective, cooperative movement is failing. So it is all about individuality. It is all about me, everything is me. So we need to bring in an innovative ideas. So in order to sustain and bring back the life in cooperative movements, it is not that there is a tool. There is a tool called farmers, former producer organization, former producer companies, through which we can promote beekeeping. If you spread beehives in your agricultural fields, at least 2 boxes for an acre, you make sure that pollination is done. 30 to 90% of the yield, depending on crop, will be enhanced. And not only that, productivity factors are different. Size, weight, numbers, and also the quality. When efficient pollination is done on time, everything changes. And this is an activity where you don't have to trust only with men. Even women can do it at their backyard, at their kitchen garden, and anywhere, because honeybees will be going for about 1 to 2 kilometer radius from their beehive. So this is another effort that we are doing is, we are converting honey hunters into beekeepers. You know, when we talk about tribal and their rights, we say that they deserve forests more than us. I totally agree with that. But what I have seen in the forest is something different. There is a demand and supply situation came into the tribal fraternity also. The trader of outside the forest is demanding tribal leaders to get more honey. So they are going and chopping off everything. Initially, they used to consume honey for themselves, for their family, at least for their village. Now it is not happening like that. So when we step in to do something better, so we sometimes ruin the system. So what we are trying to do is, there is a tribal group called Jenu Kuruba. So we are trying to teach beekeeping for them and to do sustainable beekeeping. So last but not the least, now we are promoting urban beekeeping. We are conducting workshops here. Urban is something that we are really looking into impact, because especially the school children, when they get to know about honeybees, they start to study about ecology. They start to study about the ecosystem, bee biology, and everything. So they start to Google about it. And we have seen changes in the children. And we are expecting some sort of impact investment into this field for the future. So we should bring focus and attach as much importance to save bees. And that is how we can really save the ecosystem around us. Thank you.